Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at a series of reactive intermediates, including radicals, carbanions, and carbenes. If you haven't watched the video on Introduction to Carbocation Intermediates, please go back and watch that now, because some of the topics we'll discuss were discussed at length there, and they're foundational to our work with these intermediates. So we'll begin today with radical intermediates. A radical is a species that has an unpaired electron. So in organic chemistry, that would be a carbon atom that has three bonds and then a lone electron. So not a lone pair, but one single electron that's unpaired on it. They're neutral because they have a valence of four electrons, like a carbon atom does when it's neutral, but they're very reactive because of that unpaired electron. They don't have a full octet. They are stabilized because they're electron deficient in the same way that carbocation intermediates are, by induction from neighboring carbon atoms and by hyperconjugation from neighboring carbon atoms and their bonds to other atoms. So in terms of relative stability, the most stable radical will be a resonance stabilized radical where that reactive intermediate can be shared across multiple atoms. And then in the same vein as carbocations, the more substituted the radical is, the more stable it's going to be. So tertiary is more stable than secondary, than primary, than methyl. The second reactive intermediate we'll look at is a carbanion. So anion means negative charge. Carbanions are specifically carbons with a negative charge. A carbanion would have three bonds and one lone pair of electrons on it. Because carbon is not very electronegative, when those R groups can be electronegative atoms, that helps to stabilize the carbanion. So for example, if I had a negative charge on a carbon that had very electronegative fluorine atoms on it, those electronegative fluorines could pull electron density away from the carbon and stabilize that negative charge that carbon has. So carbanions, like all the other reactive intermediates that we've seen, are stabilized by resonance because you have a charge or a reactive intermediate delocalized over multiple atoms, which is always going to be a stabilizing force. When it comes to the substitution of carbanions and their relative stability, the order is actually flipped from what we see with carbocations and radicals, and that's because carbons are not very electronegative and they're not providing any stability by being next door, because they're not pulling electron density away and towards themselves to stabilize that negative charge. And actually, the more carbon atoms there are around that carbanion, the less stability it's going to have. So a methyl carbanion will be more stable than a primary or a secondary, and the least stable will be the most substituted tertiary carbanion. The last intermediate that I want to briefly mention is called the carbene. So a carbene is a carbon atom that has two bonds attached to it, and then it has a lone pair of electrons. So it's neutral, it has a valence of four, but it doesn't have a full octet, and that makes it pretty reactive. We'll loop back around to these when we start to study alkenes and their reactions, but it's important that you're able to differentiate between a carbene and a radical, and a carbene and a carbocation. So this has been a look at reactive intermediates. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends.